behind me is the number one engine of the ship. And this here is the number two engine.
Oh my God, guys, have a look inside here.
What's up, guys? Welcome back to another beautiful day at sea. And today we are going to give you the entire tour of the engine room, which has got two engines. First, we'll show you the passageway as to how far it is from the accommodation to the engine casing. And it will take us around 5 to 6 minutes to reach the engine casing. So finally, we have made it, and this is the entrance to the engine room.
Yeah, welcome to engine room.
Welcome to engine room. Thank you, Ayush. So we are right now in the engine control room of the ship, or also the brains, and this is a fully aircon place, not so hot. And I love this place because it has got multiple panels, and the fourth engineer Ayush, he's going to tell us what exactly happens here. Yeah. So Ayush.
Guys, we have two main engines in this ship.
Okay.
And these are the cams from which we are operating the ship. Not operating, like we are controlling some operational things.
Basically, all the controls and operations functions are in these parameters.
Yeah, we are operating few things from the cam.
Okay.
And we have to do manually also.
Okay, so we will go there and show you the manual operations as well. So stay tuned. Safety first, helmet, earplugs, safety shoes. And the fourth engineer is also prepared,
guys.
Ready to go, ready to rock and roll. Yeah. So this is our first pit stop. It is the coffee table. And Ayush, what exactly happens here?
Yeah, every day 8 o'clock morning we have toolbox meeting here.
Okay.
And we are discussing what we are going to do and who is going to do. Okay.
Okay. So roles and responsibilities of every day are discussed on this table, and we have cookies. So we are right now in the high voltage room. So Ayush, what exactly is high voltage room?
Yeah, high voltage. This is a high voltage room, guys. And in this we have a circuit breakers for the machineries which have a high voltage, like a 6.6 kilovolt.
Okay, 6.6 kilovolt. So this is the circuit breakers?
Yeah, it's our circuit breakers.
These are circuit breakers. Okay. So this is the LP drum. Right?
Yeah, this is the LP drum, and in which we are making steam from the exhaust gas, and which is used for the steam turbines.
Okay. So exhaust gas for the steam turbine. So guys, these are the aircon units for the high voltage, right?
This is for high voltage room, and this is for ECR.
This is for the ECR. So this was the number one deck. Now we will go to the E2. So Ayush, ready?
Yeah, ready. We will go to E2 deck.
E2 deck.
Check that out, guys. It's massive. So, Ayush, what is this big machinery?
Yeah, actually, this is the auxiliary boiler, and which is used for making the steam.
You see this gigantic machine. It is. What is it, Ayush?
Yeah, this is the economizers, which is used for making the steam from the exhaust gas.
Okay. And guys, have a look at this.
Guys, these are the fuel tanks for different grade of fuel.
We are right now in the purifier room. There's a lot of interference, but these are the fourth engineer's babies.
Yeah, in the purifier room we have purifiers and fuel changeover units and fuel oil supply and booster pumps.
Okay. So this is the sewage treatment plant, which is only for the engine room, and for the accommodation we have it in the forward. So this was our number 2 platform, and now we will go to the number 3 where the main engine is situated. So behind me we have a few spares, as you see, and let's ask Ayush what exactly each of these are. So Ayush, what is this one first of all?
This is the exhaust valve, and this is the two liners.
Liners, okay. And this over here?
Cylinder cover along with the exhaust valve.
Okay. So Ayush, why are they kept over here like this?
Actually, these are the spare for the main engine. So in case of breakdown, we just use this one.
Okay, so for breakdown. Let's move on to the heart of the ship, the main engine. This is the main engine we have, the baby of the ship, two of them, and let's ask the fourth engineer what exactly is the power of this engine.
Yeah guys, this engine has 7 units and it is making 23.5 megawatt power. Okay. And this is a MAN B&W electronically controlled engine.
So Ayush, what is this big particular thing which we have?
Yeah, this is the spare piston rod.
And that?
That is the main engine lube oil pump.
Okay. So guys, massive structures. So we are now in the port side generator room, and over here we have two generators, DG number 1 and
DG number 3.
DG number 3. So Ayush, what is the power output of this one DG?
Yeah, DG1 is a 9 cylinder and it is making 4.5 megawatt.
Okay.
And DG3 is 6 cylinder and making 3 megawatt.
Okay, so two different varieties. So let's give you a cinematic shot of this. So guys, like Ayush was telling you, this is a 6 cylinder DG, so a smaller version, and this is like the DG number 3. So guys, behind me we have got the air compressors, and Ayush, what are they used for?
Yeah, this is the main air compressor which is used for making the air, and this air is used for starting the main engine and for other purposes.
Okay,
also.
So we're starting the main engine.
1, 2, and 3. And Ayush,
what is these things here?
Yeah, these two are the working air compressors. So in which we are also making air, and that is for control air system.
Okay.
Guys, this is for the air bottle for the control service air, and this is for starting generators, that is generator starting air bottle.
It took us 2 hours to cover just 3 decks of the engine room, since you know we've got 2 engines which you've seen now, and now we're in the massive workshop of the ship. So let's see what all we have here. And Ayush, just can you tell us what all things?
So this is the toolbox, like a tool board in which we have a lot of tools, so we can take tool from here.
Okay, it's a big workshop, guys.
And this is the lathe machine.
Lathe machine.
So guys,
okay.
Hope you know what lathe machine is working.
Yes, exactly.
And this is a metal cutting tool. This is in which we are using like a metal bar. If we want to cut, we will use this one.
Okay, so we cut metal
so,
bar here.
No need to use hexa blade, just like a automatic hexa blade.
Okay, perfect. So we will just be entering the welding part of the workshop. So here it is. And I think there's some work going on, Ayush.
Yeah, his work is going on. He's making something this fitter is doing.
Okay.
And this is the gas welding station.
Okay.
And here we can do arc welding also. There is an arc machine also.
Arc welding machine. Okay. This is arc
one.
This is the arc welding machine. Okay. So as you see, we are self-sufficient. Many things over here. Also, a few more things. Yeah, Ayush.
This is a drill machine.
Okay, drill
so
machine.
We can drill some. If we want to drill, we just come here.
Yes.
And this is the best thing in the workshop. That is aircon.
Aircon. Correct. So the best place on the engine room is the ECR and the workshop. Rest is all pretty hot and humid, and you
this
know.
Is one more cam from which we can acknowledge the alarm and see what is going on, same like we have in ECR.
Okay, so we'll also enter the storeroom where we keep all the spares. It's a massive room. You can have a look. Wow.
Yeah, this is like storeroom, which is the most important thing on board.
Yeah.
So if we have a spare, then only we can do anything.
Correct. Spares are always required.
Yeah.
And you can see it's a huge place. If we go further. My God, guys. This is even bigger than the Emma Maersk workshop. Not the workshop also, and even the stores room. So beautiful place. And yeah,
we have computer also, so we can do some work also.
From here, yeah? Okay. So we will exit the workshop now, and this is the number 2 engine. So we'll be going now to the last platform, that is number 4 platform, and after that it is more or less the end. So let's go. So guys, we are now in the bottommost section of the engine room. You can see the massive machinery here. So Ayush, what are these circular things which we have behind? Yeah, actually this is the crankcase relief door. So in case of crankcase explosion, these doors are open.
Okay, in case of explosion, they will open up.
Yeah, this is like a safety valve.
Safety valve, okay.
So guys, have a look at that major gear. I don't know what it is called. Ayush, what is that?
Flywheel for the main engine.
Okay, flywheel for the main engine.
Yeah, this is the transmitting power to the propeller.
Okay. Massive guys, have a look.
It is huge. Huge.
Oh my God, guys. Have a look inside here. Ayush, why have we opened this engine?
Yeah, actually this is a crankcase for the main engine. We open because tomorrow we have to do a crankcase inspection. That is a monthly job, yeah?
For inspection they have opened, and what is this thing?
This is a connecting rod.
Connecting rod, okay. And that is connecting to the?
Crank web.
Crank?
Web.
Web, okay.
And that is a piston rod, what we just saw outside.
That's the piston rod which we saw outside, and this is huge guys, it's massive.
Ayush, what is this small thing?
Yeah, this is a turning gear for turning the engine when we are doing some maintenance and
okay.
We have to do some inspection, we engage this turning gear and run by this electric motor.
So guys, finally we have reached the end.
Dead end, yeah.
Dead end of the ship. And if we go inside, outside we have the propeller and then the rudder. But first, let us show you the shaft.
Yeah, shaft.
Shaft. What exactly does it do?
Yeah, this is the intermediate shaft. It is connecting the flywheel with the propeller of the ship.
Propeller of the ship?
Yeah, basically it is transmitting power from flywheel to the propeller.
Okay. So this is like the rod which is connecting the
shaft.
Yeah. And we have something over there which we'll show you. Behind me you see a set of alarms and sirens, as you see. And we'll just ask what exactly this is.
Yeah, this is called light signal column. So in this we can see and hear there is some noise also coming. This is for somebody is calling and we get engine alarm. And that is water mist and CO2 alarm and fire alarm.
So we have a list over here, yeah?
Yeah, it's just start blinking the lights.
Okay.
And this is for testing.
Okay. And us, we have the shaft generator motor, and it can be used for two things, which Ayush will tell us. Ayush.
Yeah, this is used for making electricity.
Okay.
So when weather is okay and we are making some certain RPM, then we use this one as a generator.
Okay. And other thing?
And when it is like a rough sea outside and we are not making a, we are running in shallow water, that time we can use this as a motor mode.
We have the ballast water treatment system, and it is used for one thing, which is?
Yeah, in case when we are doing deballasting and ballasting, that is called ballast exchange. So before doing deballasting, we just treat with this ultraviolet lights, and it's like a treatment for before discharging.
Okay. So Ayush, what all do we have generally in the bottom platform?
Yeah, bottom platform we have lot of pumps.
Pumps
like a ballast pump, bilge pump, and our seawater pump. Lot of pumps. I cannot tell how many numbers.
So if you all were wondering that we take stairs all the time, that's not the case.
We have an elevator, yeah?
Yeah, this is much required, and if this goes kaput, then
yeah, it's hard life on board.
Hard life on board. So, finally, we took the elevator now after almost 3 hours, and we'll now go to the B deck where we have two cabins in which the engineer stays when they have a duty. So let's enter the room now, and hopefully it is nice and clean.
Oh, okay. This looks good. It's a normal standard cabin which we have. The cabin in the accommodation are much... Yeah, excuse the sweat. The cabin in the accommodation is much bigger, but this serves the purpose.
It's enough for duty engineers.
Only
and
for...
we have alarm panel also. So if you get alarm,
yeah,
then it keep in your cabin, just acknowledge the alarm.
Okay. And also we've got the washroom attached. So, looks good. Nice and proper. So guys, that is more or less our entire engine. But we cannot cover this in one video. This requires like 5, 6, 7, 8 videos. So do let us know in the comment section that we should make more, yeah?
Ayush, anything else left?
No, enough for today.
Enough?
Huh? We cannot cover in one day.
Yeah.
So guys, that was more or less our engine room.
Yeah, our engine room, yeah.
Hopefully we've covered many of the things. But like you said, it'll take more videos to cover. So if you did like the video, don't forget to
like, share and subscribe.
Like, share and subscribe, guys. And we will make a dedicated video with Ayush. It's his day in life as a fourth engineer on board. So see you later.
Few moments later.
Back to the accommodation. So guys, finally we have reached the accommodation after more or less 3.5 hours, and let's look at the number of steps we've taken.
Yeah.
So 4,212 steps only in the engine room.
Engine room, yeah. And we are doing every day like a 6 hour, 7 hour same thing.
It's crazy, guys. These guys always remain fit. So
yeah.
If you want to be an engineer, it's not an easy job.
Yeah.